Viktor Frankl, one of the most well-known authors, writing some of the books that are viewed in America as one of the most powerful books ever printed. Viktor Frankl, who lived from March 26, 1905 to September 2, 1997, who survived at least four concentration camps. He writes the following in his book, Man's Search for Meaning, page 65 and 66. We who lived in concentration camps can remember the men who walked through the huts comforting others, giving away their last piece of bread. They may have been few in number, but they offer sufficient proof that everything can be taken from a man, but one thing, the last of human freedoms, to choose one's attitude in any given set of circumstances, to choose one's own way. And there were always choices to make. Every day, every hour, offered the opportunity to make a decision which determined whether you would or would not submit to those powers which threaten to rob you of your very self, your inner freedom. Bechirat chavshit, free will. In this week's Parsha, Parsha's Vayera, God tells Moshe something very extraordinary. V'chizakti et lei Pharaoh. I am going to harden Pharaoh's heart. He's not going to be able to allow you to leave Egypt. Maimonides, in his introduction to Pirkei Avos, he has eight chapters of introduction to the sixth chapter work of Pirkei Avos. He says, why and how can Pharaoh be punished when he's lost his free will? And Maimonides answers that he's not punished for that. He's not punished for not letting the Jewish people out once God hardens his heart. All of his punishment, including the hardening of his heart, is because of his criminal acts, because of the way he interacts with the Jewish people prior to that point. The loss of free will, the loss of his humanity, is the first stage of his punishment. The notion of free will. Viktor Frankl, a survivor of four concentration camps, reminds us that whatever challenges we have in life, unlike Pharaoh, God does not harden our heart. Even if we have health challenges, financial challenges, familial challenges, we can decide how we respond to the crises and the opportunities in our lives. Parshat Ve'era, a reminder that the greatest gift that God has given us is free will. Not even God can intervene with that. And Viktor Frankl is a living testimony to that ideal. And please God, the way we engage, we will truly celebrate the greatest gift that humankind has, the gift of free will. Shabbat Shalom.